Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, members of the various clubs.
Okay, that's
J.C.'s Fraternal Order of Police. I'm honored to be entertaining for them, and boys and girls and friends. I'm sure you two know so close. Everywhere we ask, hands go up everywhere. Very rarely we have a person that never grew so close. Well, I never grew so close until I was 24 years old. And then it was because I decided I wanted to do the demonstrations in physics like I had seen the professor Donald DePaul do. He used so close. And that was the beginning of what was concerned. The beginning started in 1922 when I saw the beauty of soap bubbles demonstrated by old Professor Mayer. The actual use of bubbles started a couple years later. And so when it comes 1932, we started blowing bubbles. That had the first program. On the 32nd year of our century. Yes, there is a beauty in the soap bubble. It is the most fragile material that can support its own weight. But whether we've blown soap bubbles or not, we have blown the bubbles of life, where hopes, dreams, and aspirations are the bubbles of life. And now I would like to show you that two can blow soap bubbles, and also bubbles of blood. Two bubbles in the hollow bonds of deadlock. If there be any that should object, let him now speak or forever hold his peace. Do you take this bubble to be your awful wedded wife? Can you take this bubble to be your awful wedded husband? You are two bubbles. You are one bubble, and one bubble makes two bubbles. But it will be different now. One bubble will make plus one bubble will make one bubble. One plus one equals one. So join together, close together, to the count of 10. Join! One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Come on now. Eight. Show you that a soap bubble can roll out of fire. many people ask me if we can blow a square ball. Well, we cannot blow it. We can manipulate it. I think what they meant was a cubicle ball. Well, I'll hold them to the word square. I have a cubicle frame. Each face is a square. In order to have a square bubble, you need a support to hold it out in a square fashion. We've got to bond everything with the getting everything wet first with soap solution. It has to be wet. House will be using the tetrahedron. I'll use the cube. Here we have a big square bubble, if you want to call it a bubble. We'll call it a film. You see? I can have two square bubbles and pull out. Let's see, here we go. We will take this out right there. And here we'll take this out. And there it is, a beautiful compromise. Or rather, a bubble here. This film is a minimal. Minimal, that means that it is as small as possible. And there it is forming a bridge arch. That's known as a catenary curve. Frame solution. We get 1, 2, 3, 4. Nothing exciting about that. What we're going to attempt now is to pull up the fifth side. And if we can, we'll have a fifth side that gives us what we want. As I have to go here, oh, I see I lost it. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 1. 1 is supposed to be. Start with a fresh supply. Thank you. now trapping some air under formation. Building up the sixth side, trapping some air. We may have to repeat this. Now we're trapped there. So real carefully pull out the beautiful compromise between the sphere and the cube of what we're trying to do both. There is a compromise between the tetrahedron and the sphere. Here we have a better specimen than we had before. One side's gone, but that would be spherical bag chains. And all we need to do is to release them, like a bird out of the cage. And there. Proving the super spherical. Thank you. This is a cross between a toy and a scientific demonstration. I would like to put a bubble on this ring, two wires, and we don't need it right now. I'll need to just hold that down if I can, if that's all. Let's imagine. Now imagine this is an airplane. This is a toy now. And the airplane is going to load, and then it's going to go back to get a start, and then it's going to go out, and then it's going to wait. It'll wait. It'll wait until the order comes to proceed. And when it does, they'll start the motors are pulling and it'll go. We are using this now as a railroad. This is a Socobo railroad. And if we push it, if we open the switch here, it'll go. Watch the railroad engine. This is the engine going by itself. Engine going by itself. Now we will. Come close to me. Here, now it's up. Thank you. I appreciate your patience. Well, now it's a train. It's got a car. Now you'll notice the difference this time. Very slow. Let's put one on. Time to tell you that in our show business years ago, I always had to have a new trick for every show. This has never been seen by any public people until tonight. This is a brand new number, and that's something that makes this show a little different. Never have we had a railroad before. Huntington has been a railroad city, and so I thought this would be something. This is a toy, but it's also a scientific weapon, because when that bubble does work, pulling up a bubble, it is then doing work according to the scientific definition. It is, work is, the overcoming of resistance through space. So while we can have the three great kinds of locomotives, steam, diesel, electric, this is neither, only more like electric. You see, the electric has a potential through its trolley or through its rails. Here, the potential is a molecular potential that pulls the bubble. So actually, it's this film that does the work. It is not electric, but it is like that. It has to have rails to carry it on. Two locomotives are going to bump. Here. We're going to have a wreck. We're going to have a wreck. Let's hold there. Take the wreck. Hey, there they go. Get it off. Hey!
Yeah.
getting ready to do a trick called the jumping bubble. The bubble is going to be placed here, and then there's going to be a bubble on the inside. Now the bubble inside wants out, and the bubble on the outside wants it out too. So they may just jump.
Thank you.
celebrate. Celebrate what? Celebrate the birth of our nation. But while our nation was being born, something great was going on in France, because there the Montgolfier brothers put up the first balloon, high-air balloon, capable of taking a man up into the air. That was the first time. Man said, climb out of there. Out of there is the roof there. And then shortly, at that about the same time, Charles of France took hydrogen gas and made a balloon out of it. We have the hydrogen now, and we're going to give you some tricks with hydrogen gas. I might say that New York City, in their fire department, would not let me use hydrogen in New York. It was outlawed. They said, well, they said it's a, they didn't have anything in the category of soap bottles, and so they didn't know what to call it, so he said, it's a balloon. It's a life of a balloon. And it's dangerous, and so I'd like to let you know that you're seeing something that they couldn't even see in the north. Sound picture, which I think is the most wonderful image I have. It was a sound picture, a very simple little thing that just filled me when I was in the DePaul University under the grand old Dr. Miller. And so I worked on that. I wanted to do that more than anything else. And so we have gradually improved it. But the soap bubble is very delicate. And it's impossible to get too bright a light on it or it burns up. And so we're going to place the picture numbers on the paper card that we build a the fire up there. So we're going to do that. And then I will turn off the music occasionally so that you can see the color of the soap bubble without the disturbance. And I'll turn it back and forth so that it's not there.
Okay, turn the stage lights off.
Okay, here we go. Just a minute, we'll have it. Now you will see that the pitch of the
musical instrument will give a special design. There is a different design for every different kind of tone. But when you're dealing with the musical instruments, they're pretty well standardized. So if you're playing the piano, you use that same key over and over and over. Well, if you do that, you get the same kind of a picture over and over. So, here. I'll try something here for you to see. Here. And lower, higher tone, smaller undulation. They're very tiny for you to see. The various noises in the gift design. Well, okay, now we go. And when we get ready for some music, and then we will see the color coming in. You see the color coming in. When the light's turned on, it's just like when the sun comes out.
he becomes very sad. And I wondered a long time, why is it that young people in love have to suffer so long? Well, here it is. He just doesn't have the money to finance the campaign. So he has to go to fair. But he wants to go to the fair. But the trouble is, he doesn't have the fair. So he hitchhikes, and he finally gets to the fair where there's the scenes and the Ferris wheel and everything like that. Finally, one of his bubbles gets so grotesque that it starts acting, and he's scared, he hollers, "Help!" for fear the bubble's going to overtake him. And so that's the dream. Good luck to you all. It's lovely for you to be here, and I hope that you had a good time seeing me work these tricks as best I could. And so now,
got him. just wants me to announce that since you clapped so heartily, they agreed to do an encore number. The lucky young lady here is their granddaughter, Miss Amanda Plaster.
Are you ready? Remember, I'm right behind you.
Thank you. extreme pleasure for this board to be able to bestow this honor on one of Huntington's outstanding citizens. Respectfully submitted to Board of Public Works and Safety, City of Huntington, nomination from Schenkel Mayor, Deb Goslin, City Engineer, and Harold K. Vaughn.
I appreciate that so much because I just, Huntington means so much to me. When I was just a kid, I came into Huntington, you might say, I know, and so many things. I saw the courthouse cornerstone lady. I saw those things. I've seen Huntington through the years, and I love Huntington. And so that's so nice. And then I got to come to high school in the city, and then later on I was favored with a chance to teach in the city, and even had my children there. And so Huntington means a lot to me. And I used to say, thank you so much. I love your board, but I feel that there's so many others that are worthy and more worthy than I am, but I accept it with gratitude. And may the Lord bless us and keep us in His wonderful providence. Thank you so much.
Mr. Plaster is going to be, the curtain's going to open again in just a moment. He'll be here at center stage to meet and greet as many of you who can come up here and have a chance to shake his hand, get his autograph perhaps. He has some programs to give away. His autograph and meet again.